Welcome to the DocTeHelp video tutorial series. Today I'm going to discuss using styles in Word. When your content is authored in Word in your DocTeHelp projects, DocTeHelp transforms those files using Word styles. In fact, DocTeHelp uses heading styles to create topics, the table of contents, related topics, and more. So your Word documents need at least one style applied at the minimum, heading 1, so that your outputs work properly. But using styles has another advantage. When they are applied consistently throughout your documents, you will have consistent outputs that are easy to customize. And, very importantly, if you want to make a change to a style in the future, you can simply modify that style and rebuild your output. You don't need to search all of your documents and make numerous manual updates. Styles save you time, work, and give you flexibility. Let's dive into the styles available. You'll see how they can make your work easier. The basic heading styles are heading 1, 2, 3, and 4. As I mentioned earlier, those are the standard heading styles that are used to create topics, the table of contents, and more. You can apply them from the style list in Word, and they are also available on the DocTeHelp ribbon that is added to your Word documents. But there are other styles included with DocTeHelp's default Word templates that you can use, and even customize, to make your work easier and more efficient. DocTeHelp includes several Word templates. When you import a document into a project or create a new one, C1H no margin dot dot will be applied to it by default. Let's take a look at it. To verify the template, click the Developer tab in Word and click the Document Template button. As you can see, Word displays the available styles in the C1H no margin dot dot template in a WYSIWYG view, so you can see what they will look like. However, at first you may not know which styles to use when. Here is a quick overview of commonly used styles in this template. Heading 1, 2, 3, and 4. As I mentioned before, these are the standard heading styles. Body text. This is the standard text style. It is also on the DocTeHelp ribbon. You will most likely use this style on the majority of your content. Don't use the normal style, although it is Word's default. C1H bullet is a first level bullet. Use this style, in fact all of the bullet and numbering styles, instead of using Word's bullet and numbering buttons. C1H bullet 2 is a second level bullet. C1H bullet 2A is a second level bullet, but with an open style. C1H continue. This style is used for text that you'd like to align under a numbered or bulleted list. Mid-topic is a very special heading style that can be used within a topic. Headings using this style will appear in the topics list so that you can link to them and use them in other ways. However, unlike regular heading styles, DocTeHelp will not automatically create a new topic in online help with this style. C1H number is used for creating numbered lists. C1H number 2, this is used to create a numbered list with an additional indent. C1H continue to, like C1H continue, you could use this style to align text under a C1 number 2 numbered list item. Caption, this style is used for labeling a figure or caption. Table heading, this style is used for the top row of your tables. And table text, this style is used for table text. The styles I've just mentioned are paragraph styles. The styles list in Word will also contain character styles. Character styles should not be applied the same way as paragraph styles. If you want to clear a style in your document, select the text and choose Clear Formatting from the styles list. I think that just about covers it, but one more thing. I mentioned earlier that you could customize your styles, and that is true. See the video on editing DocTeHelp templates on DocTeHelp TV to learn more about editing styles and templates. To learn more and download a free trial, please go to DocTeHelp.com. I'm Nicky Bleiel. Thanks for watching, and thanks for choosing DocTeHelp.